Greetings, Commander.
Greetings, soldier. Anything to report? The Gladius Day has told us to keep a sharp eye. He thinks we may have some visitors this evening.
Of course, sir.
But duty, as always, is to protect the Brotherhood. All seems quiet for now.
Good, good.
Did he mention... what kind of visitor, sir?
The only kind that matters, soldier.
Yes, sir.
Of course, sir.
Carry on.
Thank you. I pray now that you give me strength in battle, that I might overcome the hordes of Satan and his children, that I might wield the flaming sword of the Archangel and defend myself with your shield of faith, and that my victories are many and my wounds few, that I might further your kingdom here on earth. If I meet death tonight, then let it be first that I cast a mighty host of demons back to the lake of fire and take aim, and then rest finally from my life.
Brother Grunfeld seems particularly uneasy this evening.
Yes, LaCroix has begun to move more openly, and Brother Grunfeld grows impatient.
Ah, yes, LaCroix. As always, Brother Grunfeld focuses only on his old nemesis.
One of us should take some food down to the prisoner.
Your he is no better than they. If not for his meddlesome diggings, the artifact would never have come here.
Yes, it is complicated matters. An interesting turn of events. Do you think it holds something?
I care not. If it does, then with God's help, we will send it screaming back to hell.
Brother Cletus says it may be him, the son of Adam, the brother killed.
If this be the end of day, then may the Lord give us strength to see them through.
So, shall we take some food down to Johansson?
Here, take mine. I am no longer hungry.
Thank you.
about him, I mean?
Brother Grunfeld?
Yes.
What stories have you heard, young brother?
There are many. Some...
Through my face. The fire I can still feel it in my wounds. They'll kill me. They'll come back with their brands and it will burn. What toxin will burn me? Again. And again and again. Their eyes, they enjoyed it. Before they come back, I'm begging you, let me out. They always come back, and it always burns. Thanks. You'll never see me again. I'm gonna go somewhere no one will ever see this face again.
I knew Johansen would lure the servants of Satan, but I set this trap for the Archfiend himself! Where is LaCroix? He is under divine protection. If you want him, come take him if you can!
I told you everything. There's no reason for you to keep me here. Let me go! I am an archaeologist. You can't hold me here like this. I am a hostage. I do not need protection. Bring me back to my hotel at once.
Yeah, okay.
Anything, just get me out of these caverns and away from these crazies. I think I'm starting to get pneumonia. The sarcophagus? You went through all that trouble for the sarcophagus? Yeah, I'll tell you. But don't you think it would be better to get out of here before those men come back? I guess if you can get all the way here, you deserve the answers. But can I make one request first? After I answer your questions, you help me escape. All right. Where should I begin? Let's start with the history of the Ankaran sarcophagus. That is a long and interesting legend, lost and found throughout the ages. Tell me, are you familiar with the Assyrians? Well, the markings on the sarcophagus seem to hint that it is from sometime between 1050 and 800 BC, which was a period of fierce expansion by the Assyrians. Oddly, for those years, only one king shows up on the historical record. While most likely he wiped all evidence of his predecessor's existence or passed the name to his heirs, one monarch, Mesarach, the one-eyed king, is given credit for the territory and achievements of this time. But he would have had to have been over 250 years old, like Dracula or something. I find it hard to believe a sarcophagus with a person as important as Mesarach could remain in, pristine or intact. An educated guess. Maybe you have not heard. It was stolen from the museum before we had a chance to open it. Usually we use equipment to carbon date. You know, it is interesting that you ask me that. The goddess on the outside of the sarcophagus was Lamastu in Assyrian myth. The engravings on and found around the sarcophagus portray a regal figure drinking the blood of his enemies. Now, this image is found in many cult. A disorder known as porphyria. In short, it is caused by a deficiency of the iron in the blood, and in many cultures, for the nobility that could con. Perhaps. Drinking the blood of your enemies is, if nothing else, symbolic. It can inspire fear in your foes and dissidents. Don't misunderstand me, in archaeology, one can spend years looking for a dig site, following local rumors. Finding and organizing a dig is the least interesting part of an archaeologist's job. Trust me, you don't want to hear about it. I don't know what would make you believe that. I have been very forthcoming with you so far. I think that maybe you are not as familiar with the process as me. Okay, I tell you, I was not even aware of the sarcophagus' existence until I received a package with no reply address in the mail. Inside was the information on how to find it and the key. Please keep it a secret or I could be ruined. That I can't be sure of, nor can anyone. but I promise you it is more likely to be filled with gummy bears than vampires. Not much, really. I'm an archaeologist, not a mythologist. But I do know that Lamastu, the Assyrian demoness, was thought to have been the inspiration for Lilith. Quite interesting. There is a surprisingly complex mechanical lock on the face of the sarcophagus. By sheer luck. How strange, you would ask. I haven't seen the key since it was loaded onto the Elizabeth Dane in Turkey. It was stolen. No, it's not the kind of key you can copy at the hardware store. It's actually very sophisticated. I've answered all your questions. Do you think now you could please get me out of here? I don't care who you are. Thank you, my friend. I don't know where you came from, but I will never forget this kindness. Baby girl, you know I got what you need.
I had a dream this afternoon, as I lay napping near where you sleep. I was running behind you in the moonlight when I tripped and fell. I looked up and you were gone. And then I noticed what I tripped on. My corpse. But I... You don't mean it! I'll leave, okay? But if you ever change your mind... Sure. All right. I'll,